ProcessBooks features a details docking window that allows you to see details of this data or any of the active objects here. The way you look at that is by choosing View and then choose Details, and you'll see this pane appear with details about that object. One more way you could do that is by just doing a right click and choosing the option called Show Details and Annotations. And now what we're seeing is that trend. And if I scroll backward in time, you'll notice I'm going backward as well in the details. So this is the raw data that's actually stored in the archive for this trend. Now, the same is true for other dynamic objects. Let me go ahead and revert to the current time. If I were to look at this, this is a dynamic element here, we'll see the values for that dynamic element. Same for all of these dynamic elements. Incidentally, if all these numbers look the same, it's because we're using some of the standard numbers that ship with the system. So those numbers are going to be the same for the tag sinusoid. Now, just as before, it's the trend in the lowest trend in the redrawing order that determines what interval of time we're looking at here. So for example, let me just demonstrate. I'll go into build mode briefly. Let me make this big enough so that we can see the time. Yeah, there we go. See the timestamp down at the bottom there? June 23rd. Let me scroll backwards to go back to, say, the 20th of June. There we go. That's an 8-hour period ending 4:45. When I click on this, we're seeing, again, that data from 4:45. And that's going to work for all these dynamic objects. Now, some other things I can point out about this object here, let me go ahead and make this a little bit bigger, is we're looking currently at data, but we could easily look at statistics, which would show me a set of statistics, standard deviation, range, etc. Again, all of these are for the period of time. You know, all of these are for the period of time that's currently selected. So as I scroll, this period of time changes, and anything, the statistics for any of these are going to change in response to that period of time. And then finally, there's an option called Point Attributes, in which we can simply look at the attributes of points.